Hello friends, welcome to Rapid Revision for Computer Science students. In this section, we will be discussing the microprograms in detail. In the previous lecture, we discussed about the micro operations. So that concept will be used in this video. So if you have not watched this the previous video, please go and watch the previous video, then only proceed. Otherwise, you will not be able to get everything that I'm saying. Okay. So let's get started. First of all, microprograms are the sequence of micro operations to perform the meaningful action in the base hardware is called microprograms. So let's subdivide this meaning and extract what is actually saying. Okay, so micro operations we already discussed in the previous video that the sequence of micro operation, not just the bundle of micro operation, the sequence is important. Okay, so it is the sequence of micro operations to perform the meaningful action. Some meaningful action is done, that is suppose addition operation we are doing, some meaningful operation is done, that instruction fetch is done, operand fetch is done, how some meaningful action is done in the base hardware is called the micro program. So base hardware which is present, that is the basic hardware, whatever we are doing the action in that with the help of sequence of micro operations to perform the meaningful action, the base hardware is called a micro program. So this is the definition for the micro program. So let's get started for the instruction fetch. Now I will tell you the agenda of the future videos. So what we'll be discussing in this video, we will be discussing about instruction fetch microprogram. In the next videos, featuring videos, we will be discussing about operand fetch. Okay, operand fetch microprogram. Then operand fetch, how we are going to fetch the operand using direct addressing mode, then using indirect addressing mode, and then also by using the operand store using direct addressing mode and interrupt cycle microprogram construction, that is for interrupt subprogram initialization, and that things will be covered in the upcoming featured videos. So now in this video we will be discussing the instruction fetch microprogram. So let's get started. Okay, so I'm giving reference to this you can see like to this diagram that we have discussed in the first video, that were consisted of the computer components, that is CPU components actually, what were there and how the control signals are generated, what are the kinds of control signals that are generated from various registers like MAR, MBR, PC, IR, SP, and register files and accumulator, and then temporary registers, and then these kind of control signals we discussed in this previous video. So again I'm saying that if you have not watched that video also, please go back and then see that, and then come back, and then you will get perfectly everything. Okay, so let's get started now we will be discussing the core part, so you have to pay attention to it. First of all, in the instruction fetch, what is done? We already done that instruction fetch. Suppose instruction is one word only, and we are storing it in a word addressable format. So suppose one word is there, and this one word instruction is supported by the CPU. So one word instruction we have to fetch from the memory. So this is what known as instruction fetch. And so instruction fetch, what we are going to do is, first of all, what I'm going to do, that program counter will keep the address of the next instruction. Okay, so PC out will tell us that to the local bus the address of the next instruction to be executed. Okay, so we are here, this is program counter. Let's do with some other color so that it will be more clear to you. Okay, so first of all we are here, then what happens is that from this via this PC out control signal, where data is circulated to the local bus, And from this local bus, we are going to MAR register, that is memory address register. Okay, memory address register will communicate with the system bus. Okay, so via system bus, we are saying that the address lines are there from MAR to system bus we are going, and then through system bus, through address lines we are here, and through address lines and read signal that are given by the control lines. Okay, suppose read signals are there, and that will be going to the memory. Okay, so memory will be activated, memory cell will be activated, and which cell is activated is told by the MAR, that is memory address register tells that which cell of the memory is to be activated. And then after that, what will be doing, the data will be transferred from here to the system bus, and through the data lines it goes to the MBR, that is memory buffer register. So transfer control goes through here, and then from MBR out control signal is generated. Then what happens is that we are going to instruction register, and then instruction register holds the opcode of the instruction, or the opcode is stored in the IR, that is instruction register, and then PC value will be incremented to PC plus step size, and step size depends on the word length of the microprocessor. Here word length is 1 word, so step size will be 1, and that will be incremented. Okay, so like that we will be able to see it. Okay, so that is how we are going to do. Now what happens is that now let's write the we can say that what is the hardware design. Now you have understood it clearly, so we will be writing it, what is the hardware design. Okay, so hardware design we are writing, so it is like a PC. From the program counter we are going to what, MAR, memory address register. Okay, from this value, that is the next instruction address is going to MAR, memory address register, and then we are going to, that is MAR is going to the address lines of the system bus, and suppose read signal is generated via the control lines of the system bus, and then what happens is that both combiningly will activate one cell of memory, that is addressed to the address lines, whatever the address is given by the address line, that will be given to us. Okay, so let's get here. Okay, yeah, one memory cell will be activated, and what memory contains what, binary data. So binary data it will contain, then this data will be going to data lines to MBR, that is memory buffer register, and from memory buffer register, and the memory buffer register, what does it contain? Okay, starting PC will contain instruction address, and we can say a memory buffer register contains the instruction, that is the opcode, and that goes to the instruction register, and then instruction will be stored in the instruction register. Okay, so this is the process for instruction fetch, and also the PC value will be incremented to the step size. PC plus step size will be stored in the PC itself. So these are the processes that are happening. Okay, so let's see what happening. As I told you that the micro operations are register to register transfer operations, so we have to discuss, we have to observe that which are the register to register operations. First of all, this PC is a register, then MAR is also a register, so this is a kind of register to register transfer. Then from MAR, then we can see that here no register is there, memory is not a register. Okay, so then data lines is not a register, then MBR is a type of register. So through crossing through one memory reference, we are going to MBR. So it is taking one memory reference, so we can say that it is not one cycle, it may take long time. Okay, so here to here, then from MBR to IR, it is also a register transfer operation. Okay, so this arrows are necessary in order to write the micro programs, so that will be able to write them more easily if we make the clear diagram. Okay, from PC to PC, we can see like from old PC value is incremented to step size, like that we can see. Okay, so for micro program, we can see like PC pro PC out, then from MAR, MAR in, then from MAR out to MAR out to MBR SB in from system, but is it is coming, therefore MAR MBR SB in. Okay, then from MBR to IR, that is MBR out to IR in, then PC out to PC in. So we have done everything. Now it's the time to write the micro program. So micro program is like this. We'll be writing micro program, that is first is T1 cycle, PC value goes to MAR, memory address register. This can be represented by the control signals PC out and MAR in. This is shown in the diagram here, PC out to MAR in. Then from 42 clock cycle, then it is showing that we are doing one memory reference, so we are denoting it like M of MAR. This is the convention to write it, M of, because one memory reference is needed here, M of MAR to MBR. This we can represent by control signals MAR out, MBR SB in, and we can notice that this is happening in the system bus because MBR SB in. What we are doing is, if you can see the diagram itself, okay. So what we are doing is from MAR, we are going to memory, then from MAR we are going to memory, then after returning we are going to MBR. So this is a part of system bus. In the meantime, we can also perform the local bus operations here. So we are performing the local bus operations. So we can utilize this time cycle. Okay, so this is a, we can say, we can utilize this cycle for increment PC. That is PC plus increment PC. Okay, PC, suppose that is a one word microprocessor. So we can write it like one. PC plus 1 PC, then we can represent it like PC out to PC in, PC out, then increment, one ALU operation is there, then PC in. This is done in local bus, so we can perform these two operations parallelly. Like I said in the previous video, one micro, we can say not operation, micro program consists of the sequence of micro operations. Okay, micro instruction contains of various more than one or more than one micro operation. So in order to, and it is also takes one cycle, so in order to make it one cycle, the operation must be performed parallelly. So we are performing it parallelly, no clashing between them, because system bus is different and local bus is different, so operations can be performed in both the buses at the same time. Okay, if it had been a local bus and this is also local bus, then if both were their local bus, then we couldn't have performed this operation. We would have to take another cycle if some clashes will occur. Okay, so we can perform this operation only if we are able to see that one bus is free, another is happening, then we can make use of the another system bus also, another bus also. If system bus is free, we can use a local bus for the another operations. Okay, so T3, suppose T3 is what, here we can see in the diagram, T3 is here, that is we are doing the value of MBR to IR, transferring the data. That is, opcode will be transferred from memory buffer register to the instruction register, that is MBR out to IR in. So that is all for the we can say instruction fetch microprogram. In the next video, we will be discussing the operand fetch during our direct addressing mode. Okay, I hope that you guys understood every part of it. And if you like the video, please like, comment, and subscribe. Bye for now. Thank you.